Hi, you're watching Hindustan Times Poll Bazi, and I'm Aditi Prasad. The Aam Aadmi Party has announced their CM face in Punjab, and yes, you're right, it's Bhagwant Mann, something that we've known all along is going to happen. Let me start the show today by bringing in Raghav Chadha from the Aam Aadmi Party, who's also co-charge of the Punjab election for the party. Congratulations, Yadav, you finally have a CM face, Raghav. And when Kejriwal had first become the chief minister, he had talked about people's referendum for every issue, every big or small issue. And then he said people will decide. That never happened. But this time, the system of taking people's feedback or sort of a referendum for the Punjab CM candidate, why now?
So the Aam Aadmi Party and Mr. Arvind Kejriwal in particular has always been a very big votary of instruments of direct democracy. If you remember, in the year 2013, when we contested the elections for the very first time, we fell short of majority. And the question before us was whether to accept outside support from the Congress or not, the party against which we fought the election. And we went to the people. We conducted 272 meetings in all 272 wards in the municipal limits of Delhi. And people overwhelmingly said that, yes, you should. We were in a dilemma. So Mr. Kejriwal has very often used instruments of direct democracy. And this time also, it would have been very easy for us to, you know, the key decision makers of the party to sit in a closed room, 7-8 of us, and we could have easily zeroed in on Mr. Mann's name, which we actually did. But we decided, and Mr. Mann proposed, Mr. Kejriwal endorsed, that, look, it's best that we go to the people. Let's speak to them. Let's seek their opinion. And it's perhaps for the first time in the history of Indian politics that a political party has nominated somebody as the chief ministerial candidate post consultation with the people of Punjab. It's merely because this decision doesn't impact the Aam Aadmi Party alone. This decision impacts the lives of 3 crore Punjabis that live in this Suba.
So notwithstanding, the voice of the people, Raghav, why do you think Bhagwant Mann is a good bet for the Aam Aadmi Party?
Look, first of all, I've known him for a very long time. In fact, I don't know, many people don't know this, that when he won the election for the very first time, I was appointed as the secretary of the parliamentary group. 4 MPs were there, and I was all 4 were from Punjab, and I was appointed as a secretary of the group to help them in, you know, their initial days in parliament, to strategize, to do floor management, floor coordination, research, give them talk, all of that. So I've been working with him for almost 7 years now, very closely, and I've seen him, mature as a politician and as a political leader. And, you know, an ordinary person coming from an ordinary household, from Satoj to Sansad, Bhagwant Mann has, proven that sheer hard work, determination, and integrity can take you places. Mm-hmm. And, he is, somebody who's always worked at the grassroots. He has a vision for Punjab. He is a man with, impeccable integrity. We trust him. And I thank Mr. Kejriwal for giving us such a wonderful Senapati in this war, which is about to begin.
Still the Senapati, not the king.
Once you win, the Senapati is crowned, no? So we're hoping that he shall be crowned.
You know, I will come to that a little later about all the talk about, Delhi calling the shots in Punjab, even if Mann wins the elections. But I will talk about that in a bit. Just one little, another small question. 2014 se pata tha ki Mann sabse popular neta hai aapke. So why was the decision taken so late, less than a month before the elections?
Well, you see, in politics and certainly in electioneering, in campaigns, one has realized that timing is everything. Timing is supreme. And as somebody who's been part of several campaigns from 2013 to now, I can tell you the timing to make a thing public or to bring something in the public domain is extremely, extremely crucial. And I think it's a matter of, any political party's own right to decide when to announce, who to announce, how to announce, all of that. And we, as a matter of political strategy, closer to the elections, have announced his candidature with the ratification from 3 crore Punjabis.
3 crore Punjabis, of which he emerged victorious. Fair enough. The Congress, on the other hand, you know, because jitne bhi polls ho rahe hain, all the opinion polls that we've seen, all of them have pitted, it's either AAP or the Congress, which is coming to power, and AAP generously ahead in some polls, generously, and slightly behind in some polls. Now, the Congress has indirectly today endorsed the incumbent Chief Minister Channi as their CM face. And I'm saying indirectly because there is no formal announcement yet from there because of the infighting between Navjot Singh Sidhu and Channi himself. But the Punjab Congress today tweeted a video of Sonu Sood saying that the real Chief Minister is someone who deserves to be at the post and not someone who declares them to be a chief ministerial candidate. I think that was an indirect dig at Navjot Singh Sidhu. But the video also ends with visuals of Charanjit Singh Channi at various programs and events. Do you think that this is now a straight fight between Channi and Bhagwan?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Yes, can you hear me? Raga? Okay, Raga, can you hear me? Okay, it seems we've lost Raga. Let me bring in our other panelist, Ramesh Vinayak, who's executive editor with Hindustan Times, and Manu Sharma, who's with the Sea Voter. I want to call, let till Raghav rejoins us and we try and get some more understanding about the AAP strategy in Punjab. Your take, Ramesh, on... Oh, yes, here he's back. So let me just quickly... Can you hear me
I'm
now?
I'm so sorry. No, there's something happened in the connection.
No problem. That's technology for us. You're back with us and that's great. But quickly, questions to you, right to the forefront. So do you think it's a straight fight? What I was asking you before you developed a technical snag, do you think this is a straight fight between Channi and Bhagwan Mann now?
Look, first of all, Congress is a divided house. Congress is essentially a fight club where this unprecedented WrestleMania seems to take place. Literally every single leader of the Congress is fighting with the other leaders. And, all hell has broke loose in Congress. Congress is in no position to even run a successful campaign, forget win the election. However, I think as far as the 2022 election is concerned, it is Kejriwal versus all. And I've said this again and again that seeing that Aam Aadmi Party is actually at the finish line, as literally every opinion poll has predicted, all these parties are likely to get together. You will see, backroom channels being activated, and all these political parties, Congress, Akali Dal, BJP, all these will get together in order to defeat and stop the Aam Aadmi Party with the common minimum program of stopping the Aam Aadmi Party. Something similar happened in the year 2017 also, when you had Mr. Naresh Gujral, the Shiromani Akali Dal member of parliament, going on record to say that votes with clinical precision were transferred from the BJP, from the Akali Dal, to the Congress party, because in first past the post system, Congress was seen to be in contest with the Aam Aadmi Party. So something similar can happen. It's not that it's AAP versus Congress or AAP versus Akali Dal. It's essentially Arvind Kejriwal versus all. That's how I look at 2022 election.
I just want my producers to bring up that chart about the Sea Voter opinion poll of January 6th, because that was the last poll that was done. And if you can bring up that chart on the screen, you see, Raghav, that 28.8% Punjabis repose their faith in Channi, and a staggering 23.3% repose their faith in Bhagwan Mann. That is also no mean feat, given Arvind Kejriwal got 17%. And if you add Arvind Kejriwal and Bhagwan Mann together, the percentage of people who prefer to see them as their favorite chief minister, it crosses the 40% mark. So yes, the Arvind Kejriwal factor that you are pointing out is absolutely correct. But the very clear thing also is that Chadni is the first Dalit chief minister that the state of Punjab has seen. And the Congress, and there is more than 30% of the population of Punjab is Dalit. How do you hope to counter that narrative, if at all?
Look, if I understand this state correctly, let me tell you, Punjab doesn't vote on caste or religious lines. I hail from this Suba and I can tell you that Punjab is by far the most secular state, religion agnostic, caste agnostic state in the country. I'll give you a small example. Bahujan Samajwadi Party started its politics in Punjab. Kashi Ramji comes from Punjab. And yet, in order to do Dalit vote bank politics, they had to shut shop in Punjab and move to another state, that is Uttar Pradesh. In fact, Mayawati ji contested from a seat in Punjab and a seat in UP. She lost the election in Punjab but won in UP simply because Punjab refuses to vote on caste lines. And you know, this notion of, you know, projecting a chief minister or placing somebody as a night watchman in the form of Charanjit Singh Channi to you know, woo the 30-34% odd population simply because they come from a particular bhaichara or a community goes against the very notion of and the core beliefs of Punjab, Punjabi and Punjabiyat. And the way I understand this state doesn't vote on caste line.
The state doesn't vote on caste line, and therefore you're trying to make a headway there. But there are a lot of people who are using that one phrase that if AAP wins, Kejriwal will be the super chief minister, that all the control will be from Delhi. How would you respond to
These are the very same people who first used to say, Aam Aadmi Party will not announce a chief ministerial phase. We said, no, we will. Then they started saying, oh, if they will, they will announce Arvind Kejriwal or his nominee from Delhi or someone as the chief ministerial phase. Once we announced Bhagwant Mann, now they say, no, we have another issue. Now Bhagwant Mann will be controlled by somebody sitting in Delhi from a remote. I mean, there is a limit to all this paranoia and propaganda that these people indulge in. I refuse to buy this. I, in fact, refuse to waste my breath on this. Let's concentrate on the job at hand, which is to win an election and then give a stable, steady, pro-people, pro-Punjab government. And that is what our aim is. We have, in the form of Bhagwant Mann, an excellent orator, a mass leader, somebody who the people of Punjab trust, and somebody who the people of Punjab want to try once. In fact, even our detractors, those who don't like us, wish to try Bhagwant Mann once as their chief minister. That's the power of the common man. And I feel, through my travels across Punjab, I've learned one thing, that people are fed up of these traditional political parties. You know, once you travel across Punjab, you will feel that people, you know, keep saying this, ki rivayati partiyon se hume ab sahara nahi lena, rivayati siyasatdan nahi chahiye, rivayati politics nahi chahiye. They don't want, you know, these traditional Akali Dals and Congresses of the world. They want something new in the form of an alternative, that is the Aam Aadmi Party.
But you have been, you know, and which is great that you've been hard selling the Delhi model of governance, so to speak, that what you did in Delhi, you will be doing in Punjab. But do you believe that there are too many populist freebies that have been given away? I mean, 1,000 rupees for every woman. And where will that money come from? Punjab is already
Look, first of all, what some people refer to as freebies, I call it the social security net. You know, kind of social security net.
Raghav, how is it a social security net if you're giving it away to everyone? It's not targeted at
It is, and I'll explain to you how. First of all, this 1,000 rupee program, this is something which is a sign-up program. People have to sign up for it. Those who are in dire need of financial assistance will sign up for this. That's point number one. Point number two, to lead a life of dignity, there is a minimum amount of electricity, minimum amount of water, minimum amount of public transport, etc., that is required. When we say in Delhi that we will give you 20,000 liters per family per month as free water, we've done a calculation based on figures given by the World Health Organization, the WHO, that this is the amount of water that is required per family, per person, and multiplied it by 4 and 30, respectively, 4 being the average size of the family and 30 being the number of days in a month. So therefore, there is some application of mind that goes into this. And we are only promising that much. that one requires to lead a life of dignity.
Can the Punjab economy handle these freebies or these subsidies that you've promised? Because at the end of the day, Punjab is already borrowing to service its existing debt.
Please, well, we've drawn a complete financial blueprint. I understand that the state of Punjab is under tremendous debt, which is clocking close to 3 lakh crore. From the outside, we see it as 3 lakh crore. Maybe once we enter government, we'll probably be given a figure higher than this. We don't know that yet. There could be hidden liabilities which don't expressly show up in the balance sheet. So these are some things that we'll, of course, be encountering once we step into the government. But yes, we have done a full financial blueprint as to from where money will flow, what will be the sources of revenue augmentation, how will we plug revenue leakages, and also how will we channelize the current revenues that don't fall in the kitty of the government, how that will flow back to the government.
All right. My last question to you, Raghav. Politicians often, especially during the election season, make very new personal allegations against one another. Do you think that the allegations or the personal remarks against Bhagwant Mann, especially related to his drinking, are going below the belt, and why so?
Look, first of all, it is the people of Punjab that have decided Bhagwant Mann's candidature as the chief ministerial face of the Aam Aadmi Party, number one. Number two, I feel that a person should certainly be judged by the work that he does and not by what he does in his personal life. And lastly, Aam Aadmi Party is perhaps going to be the only political party that is going to announce a chief ministerial face in the year 2022 for the Punjab elections. Akali Dal is unlikely to announce. Congress is unlikely to announce. The SSM has not announced. The BJP is unlikely to announce. So the only party that has actually, gathered the courage, for a lack of a better phrase, I could say, to announce a chief ministerial candidate. All other parties have miserably failed as far as this is concerned. So I'd first request them to name their chief ministerial face before taking pot shots at us.
First name their chief ministerial face before taking pot shots. So with this election, it seems, I know I had said that I will free you up at 6:25 because you have other commitments. Yeah. So I'm going to let you go. But one last word. With this election, do you feel that AAP's national ambitions, pan-national ambitions, will finally see fruition
let us first win Punjab. I am most certain, as somebody who's been working very hard in the state for little over 1 year, I can tell you, it appears that we are winning the state. We will be forming a government very, very soon. And it is not for the Aam Aadmi Party or the leadership of the Aam Aadmi Party to draw up a national plan. It is for the people to decide if they want to test the Kejriwal model of governance, if they want to experience the Kejriwal model of governance in their respective states. We have a proven track record in Delhi. People of various states want that model to be replicated in those states. And wherever there is yearning for change, Aam Aadmi Party will certainly be there.
All right. Thank you so much, Raghav, for
Thank
joining
you.
Us. Thank you. And let me continue this conversation with our other guests, which is Manu Sharma from Sea Voted and Ramesh Vinayak. Ramesh, do you share Raghav's optimism as far as Bhagwant Mann and his candidature is concerned? And will he be able to stand tall side by side if Congress decides to project Channi as their CM face, although they haven't done yet?
Well, Aditi, this AAP's announcement today on Bhagwant Mann was pretty much expected. You know, I didn't see any major surprise there. But the way Aam Aadmi Party kind of went about it in a very kind of well choreographed exercise they ran, in terms of opening phone lines for people of Punjab to decide to suggest the name of chief ministership. It's a very smart exercise which they have done. You know, they created a kind of hype. And now when, Bhagwant Mann's name has finally been announced after, they said that 93% of over 22 lakh people who called up have favored Bhagwant Mann. So I would say that, AAP has definitely kind of created a kind of hype, created a kind of new situation, you know, which works to their advantage, you know. And Raghav is right in saying that, you know, AAP is the first party to have explicitly announced its chief ministerial face in Punjab so far. Though Sukhbir Badal has also said, you know, he told me in one of the interviews last month that, you know, he would be the face of Shomani Akali Dal for chief ministerial post. But the party hasn't really formally kind of announced this. And in Congress, again, you know, there is a bit of confusion and hazy situation. Similarly, BJP, Punjab Lok Congress, you know, Alliance of Amrinder, they haven't really announced any chief ministerial face so far, and nor do they intend to. So I guess, you know, AAP has definitely taken a lead over other parties. And there is no doubt, Aditi, that Bhagwant Mann was an obvious choice. He is the most popular leader of Aam Aadmi Party in Punjab.
Or hai kaun Aam Aadmi Party ka leader, Ramesh? There is only Bhagwant Mann that we keep hearing about.
Yes, that's right. You know, because he is one of the founding members of AAP in Punjab, you know, and I have very closely followed his political career. You know, he first cut his teeth in politics in 2011 when he had joined Manpreet Badal's People's Party of Punjab, you know. Manpreet Badal, who had split from Shromani Akali Dal and floated a party just before assembly election in 2012. And Bhagwant Mann had joined that party and had even contested election from Sangrur district, you know. And but his real breakthrough came when he joined Aam Aadmi Party in 2014. And his first election as you know, Lok Sabha candidate, he won with a resounding margin, you know, over 2 lakh votes, highest in Punjab, you know, that was his margin. And so he has stayed loyal to AAP, you know. Mind you, in 2014, Aditi, AAP, when it burst, you know, on Punjab scene, they had got 4 seats out of 13 in Punjab, you know. And out of those 4 MPs, 3 fell out with Aam Aadmi Party. You know, they left the party, you know, in the subsequent years. Only Bhagwant Mann has stayed the course, you know. He has kind of stuck to Aam Aadmi Party. So in the process, he has cultivated a kind of a profile which is now pan-Punjab profile. So he is a crowd puller, no doubt about that, known for being a very engaging speaker, you know, who can make a, you know, a fantastic speech in the parliament, you know, in his trademark comic style. And also, you know, when he speaks in the public, you know, one can see that he can keep the audience spellbound. So these are the qualities. And also, I tend to agree with the, you know, Raghav, when he said that, you know, Bhagwant Mann, you know, enjoys a fairly high degree of integrity. We haven't heard any issue of corruption, you know, any such blind
below the belt wali bahut hain jo ki unke alcohol consumption pe now Congress is trying to take pot shots at that. But let me bring in Manu Sharma. Manu, aap mujhe bataiye, and if you can, Sea Water ka ek survey hua tha early January mein, first week of January ka survey tha. Usme Aam Aadmi Party ko 40% votes mile the, National Congress ko 36% votes aap keh rahe milenge. That's the vote share jo aapne kara tha, which means you Sea Water survey, the last survey opinion poll that you did, put Aam Aadmi Party in pole position in Punjab. Now that they have declared Bhagwant Mann as their CM candidate, kya aapko lagta hai ki usse unko fayda hoga aage chal ke, kya kya kaisa rahega? I think unmute kar dein please.
Haan. See the game in okay, so the game in Punjab, psychologically speaking, is about which party does better in its stronghold. So it's all about relative performance. Maja and Doaba are the strongholds of Congress, and Malwa currently is being led by Aam Aadmi Party. Now, with this projection of an organic leader, organic Jat leader that carries rustic charm, Aam Aadmi Party can do better in Malwa. And if they sweep Malwa, you know, they'll be in a further advantageous position. Now, so far, our projections and our numbers have not, you know, been predicated on a leadership projection. So there was some bit of confusion about, you know, who will be the leader and perhaps from which community and perhaps what would be the power arrangement like. Like some people were saying that perhaps Arvind Kejriwal would take over. Some were suggesting, you know, somebody from his family might actually be there. So all that has been laid to rest. Bhagwant Mann is a rustic, I would say, organic leader who was a comedian and a satirist initially. I mean, he was a very popular comedian. I would say, in a way, he's a contribution of T-Series to politics. And he's taken off. He does enjoy good reputation in terms of integrity. And let me make a point about this whole alcohol business. Now, being a voter in Punjab and a Punjabi, I can attest to you that this kind of an allegation that you know, Bhagwant Mann drinks a lot or perhaps he had a drinking problem or whatever, this doesn't cut much ice in Punjabi electorate. You know, it might be an issue in some other states, but to say that this will be viewed as a deep personal flaw, I think his political opponents are overdoing it. You know, beyond a certain point, it won't matter whether or not, you know, these allegations have any water or not. Again, another thing I would like to make one special point is about the yearning in Punjab to have local leadership. Currently, what we see as a phenomena in BJP, in Congress, is that the appointments are made from Delhi. The organic local leadership is highly dependent upon the high command culture. Now, people can argue that Aam Aadmi Party has done simple window dressing, but in actually giving it a veneer of, you know, American style primary, they have managed to create an aura of, you know, stakeholdership for the average voter and the average Punjabi. And it's a very, I would say, interesting move made by Aam Aadmi Party.
Yeah, you know, let me just take this to you, Ravish. Congress not declaring their chief ministerial candidate, even now. I mean, irrespective of the Punjab Congress tweets today, portraying, sort of indirectly hinting at Channi. But these indirect hints are not going to really get them anywhere, do you think? They need to have a face. The infighting narrative has to go for them to make any lasting dent in these elections, in my opinion. What is your view on that?
Well, Aditi, the past experience showed that whenever Congress hasn't announced its CM face, they have lost elections. 2007, they didn't announce the CM face. They lost. 2012, they didn't nominate their chief ministerial face. They lost. In 2017, they made a break from this and announced Captain Amrinder Singh at their CM face, and the party won, you know. So this is the recent experience. But now the party is really caught in a bind, you know. It's not going to be easy for Congress High Command to declare Mr. Channi or Mr. Sidhu as their CM face. So far, their position is that election would be fought under collective leadership. You know? And the sense that we are getting is that eventually the party will have to throw some hint, you know, as to who would, you know, lead the party.
I think it has to be a decisive call that needs to be taken there. Because now clearly AAP has portrayed a CM face. They've given you a leader to deal with, organic, from Delhi, from wherever. The point is that they have a CM face now. Congress still does not have a CM face, and that narrative of infighting is might be hurting its prospects, its poll prospects more than helping them.
Definitely. I think
the ball is in their court now. So the AAP has played their part. Now the ball is in the Congress's court to sort of take this forward, play it back, throw the ball back, do something with it to take this Kela forward, so to speak, in Punjab. Thank you so much for joining us for this broadcast. I wanted to keep it short and succinct at 30 minutes, so I'm going to drop it here. But any last thoughts before you go, Manu, Ramesh? Manu, you want to?
Yes. Well, look, I mean, the key here is to understand that today Congress is bereft of any tall Jatsik leader. And that is a significant dent in their, let's say, preparation. With the, you know, with Captain Amrinder Singh leaving them, this is the first election that's going to take place in post-Amrinder era. And it will be interesting as to how the Sikhs and especially the Jat Sikhs of rural Malwa look at it.
All right, thank you.
My thoughts are that AAP has definitely stolen the march over other players in Punjab. And now this will put, you know, a kind of pressure on Congress to take a call on their chief minister's face. And it won't be an easy call, given, you know, the kind of unbridled ambition that Mr. Sidhu has, and also parties that kind of strategic move to put Mr. Channi, you know, as chief minister of Punjab to basically consolidate the Dalit vote bank, which is a very substantial vote bank and is a poll swinger in Punjab, you know. So for Congress to resolve this predicament won't be easy. So next few days will decide which way will they kind of take this call.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us for this broadcast. I'll leave it on that note. Thank you, Manu. Thank you, Ramesh. And of course, thanks to Raghav Chadda, who was with us and is and had to leave early because of a former commitment to another news channel. Thank you, viewers, for joining us for this broadcast. We'll keep coming back to you with more. Stay tuned tomorrow, 6 p.m. We'll be back with another episode, another edition of Poll Buzz.